The S21 Ultra is known for its crazy camera shots, but that also makes it the biggest problem for its protection. Notice how large a surface area and bump the camera module is. Undoubtedly, the camera bump is the major statement piece of the S21 Ultra, and it is this iconic look which makes it stand out from other flagships. However, it also seems to be the most dangerous part of it, and which needs to be the emphasis of protection.
Ang video na to ay handog ni cdkoffers.com. Marami kang mahahanap na iba't ibang uri ng software dito. May games, apps, activation codes for Windows 10. Check out our video on CDK Offers in the video description. Mabilis, mura, and syempre legit dito. Madali lang mag-order, search for the software you need, add to cart, check out, daan ka sa payment options nila, wala pa isang minuto, finished. May legit working CDK ka na sa software na pinili mo. Gamitin ang aming promo code para makakuha pa ng extra 20% discount sa purchase mo. Kung naghahanap ka ng mura, legit, and original software, check out cdkoffers.com.
Our first case is the Spigen Crystal Flex. Spigen is a familiar case maker brand, and I have been buying their cases since the iPhone 6 Plus back in 2014, and it is always the first choice I go to after I buy a new phone, mostly because it is a known brand. I like their cases in general, and because they usually make dependable cases for when you've just bought a new phone that needs protection ASAP. The case also comes with a cleaner in case the case comes in contact with something which stains it. I haven't used it and I am saving it for a rainy day. In keeping with the minimalist approach, the innards of the case do not have additional cushioning for the sides of the phone. The Crystal Flex, as the name suggests, is flexible and installation was quite easy. Some phone cases make it difficult for people to install their phones into it. But the biggest problem I have always had with cases was taking the phone out. Taking the phone out of some cases sometimes leads to the case either breaking or forces you to work hard for it to release. With the Crystal Flex though, it is smooth slipping it on and slipping it off. However, if you look closely, it isn't really transparent to begin with. It has these white dots which encapsulate the outer layer of the case. They are noticeable enough that it defeated the reason as to why I got this case. It also seems to show an ever so slightly blue tint, so it isn't 100% white. The buttons are the same material as the case and they fulfill their purpose in protecting the keys. However, they aren't particularly interesting to touch, to be honest. The camera bump and the immediate sides of the phone are protected by the lip, which is there to act as the first contact between your phone and death. The major problems I have with the case is that it offers no grip whatsoever. If your hands are moist, even with just ordinary clamminess, you will definitely feel a form of hesitance that this phone will slide through your hand by mistake if you aren't careful to maintain a tight grip. Most people get a clear case so that the case could vanish. But the layer of tint is heavy and the white dots makes the case even more pronounced. What you also need to watch out for with cases like this is yellowing over time. Some reviews have reported that the case came yellowed out of the box. I myself have a Note 9 case which has begun to yellow but lasted 2 years but which happily held on before my S21 upgrade. I got this case for 940 pesos complete with shipping. On Amazon in the US, you can get this for $12. I'll leave links in the description below for both. Hey! If you like what you're watching so far, please consider liking and subscribing to Hardware Sugar where we generate regular tech content. Rinkey is a new brand to me altogether, but it stood out because of their simple but rugged design. This is the Rinkey Onyx, which comes in black, dark blue, gray, and variations of the case with graffiti style art. The inner layer of the case is encased with rubber padding to provide further protection to the phone while it's inside. Just like the Crystal Flex, the Onyx flexes as well. However, because the sides are made of rubber, I don't think I would be expecting any yellowing over time. Installation of the phone into the case and removing it are both easy and straightforward. This comes in handy for when I want to clean my phone once a week, something which I recommend everyone does because dirt and water seep into the case and may leave permanent stains if not cleaned every now and then with a microfiber cloth. The Onyx has excellent grip. The textured dotted sides make me feel as though I just leveled up the feel of an already premium phone. Holding the phone with the Onyx makes the phone feel more substantial, yet more protected. Sometimes, I genuinely pick up the phone when this case is on just so I could feel the heft of the phone. One drawback of these very small cavities, however, is that dirt occasionally gets in, and if it's white dirt, it detracts from the look of the case and it takes some effort to remove it because they are nestled in deep. However, I think this is a very minor issue. The matte black finish is a much more welcome color change from the Spigen, and the look of the material reminds me of egg carton cardboard, but it is much more pleasing to the touch than that, of course. It also has these three supporting mounds which prop up your phone so as to lessen any possible scratching you may cause on wood surfaces. It's also a really smart idea to prevent staining or scarring other parts of the phone while it's on top of a surface, because the phone is quite literally elevated away from anything which might damage it. Earlier, I mentioned that the camera module is what you want to protect the most. And while the Spigen does do that, the Onyx takes it a step further by adding sleek black reflective plastic which refract with light alongside the camera modules. It thus makes the case blend more into the phone to the point that you sometimes forget that it is there. In fact, you can even say that the black reflective plastic even augments and makes the camera modules even more impressive. The phone keys are covered by protruding rubber pods, which also are nice to touch. Some phone case manufacturers choose to turn these into metal buttons, but that would detract from the already stealthy matte black look the case successfully achieves. There's also a raised lip on the front so that it is what absorbs the impact and not the glass. I got the Onyx for 840 pesos or a whole 100 pesos cheaper than that of the Spigen. Again, I'll leave links in the description below. If it hasn't been clear yet, I am very happy with this case, and it has been my go-to daily driver case ever since it arrived. Here in Hardware Sugar, Anton and I use our cell phones for all the camera shoots, and so cell phone protection is an even more important thing now more than ever. In conclusion, I don't think I'll be using the Spigen case as much because I have naturally gravitated towards the Rinke Onyx. Don't get me wrong though, I'm sure the Spigen case can provide the usual protection, it's just that because of the much more stealthy design, the mirrored plastic around the camera modules, the subtly raised mounds, and the textured grip of the Onyx makes this a no-brainer for me. Consider the Onyx as not so much a case which disappears, but a case which actually adds to the beauty of the phone. And you can't say that about many cases. And I want to give a special shout out to our top fans, IPX Addict, D. Pry Shun, John Ochia, Christian Espinosa, Mark Palania, and Asher Anima. Thanks guys, we really appreciate it.